Alrighty, so we're gonna drill some holes through some 2x4s and add another outlet from a 2-gang box with 2 outlets in it. And here in the country I was born in, we use a 14 American wire gauge on 15 amps and a 12 American wire gauge on 20 amps. The black is live, the white is neutral, the bare of the green is the ground, and also red and blue are live colors. There are some instances where a white wire may be live, which would be on a 220, 240 volt circuit, where it doesn't require a neutral, and also in a switch loop. So I'll show you how to install these outlets and drill holes through the studs. Okay, so we'll drill our holes in a straight line here. Along this line here. And we'll get into this one on right in the center of the stud here. Okay, so now we'll pull our number 12 wire through here. Okay, so we'll mount our box just below our turn here. I'll strip my wire here. I'll just score it up here some so I make it easier to rip. Alrighty, so now we can put our wire into our box here, and we'll staple it so it's going neat across here. Okay. So here in the country I was born in, we'll put the white on the silver colored screw and the black on the brass colored screw. Bare brown wire goes on that green screw. So first we'll take our bare ground wire, make our loop the direction that the screw turns, put it around our screw like that, close the loop the direction that the screw turns, make it nice and tight. We'll strip our white wire with our number 12 hole. Make sure it's long enough to get in under the pressure plate and that it's not quite long enough, so take some more off. Hold it up. That's perfect length there, so we put it in our hole there. Make sure it's tight. We'll flip it over. We'll do the same with our black wire here. Our black is live wire. Make sure it's long enough, and it is. Put it up into our hole. Make sure the insulation goes up to the bottom of the hole there. Okay. Now we can fold this into our box. We'll keep our ground, we'll go up and down with our, keep our black and white going this way and our ground on the bottom here. Okay, we'll put our other screw in here. Okay, so I'm going to push that wire in through there. Okay, so we pulled our wire through. Hi, Bob. That's right.
Where are you?
Right in here.
In the office?
Yep. Okay, my camera's gone, so I'll pause it.
Pause the camera.
Yep. Okay. Okay, so we have our feed through from this out over to this one, so we will check that onto this one.
Okay.
Yep.
Are you taping?
Yes.
Sorry.
This will only take about 10 minutes. So our ground wire goes back in here like this. And this out back into the buster. And our ground wire back out the way here. Make sure it's tight. Okay, so we'll push this back into our box. Just finish it by hand so I don't strip the holes out. And make sure this ground wire is out away from everything. Push my wires back. Okay, so now we can have our white wire up. We'll strip it here. We'll hold it down here where we're going into. It's about, let's see if that's going to go in all the way. And yes, it does. It's long enough. Make sure everything's all nice and tight. Okay, I'll turn this around. Make sure our ground wire stays down here on the bottom. I'll strip our black wire here. I'll hold it up to our terminal here, make sure it's long enough. It looks like it's long enough, so I'll put it in our hole. Gotta open it up. Put it in all the way, make sure insulation is butted up to the back of the device there. Make sure everything's nice and tight. Okay, we'll push this back into our box. I'll make sure our wires clear the screw holes here. In the way. supposed to be stupid, so you know what you do? You take it out. And you destroy it. Now nobody will have to fight with it. And I'll finish it by hand so I don't strip the wool out. And I'll just look and make sure our screws aren't hitting the wires, and we are all set. Alrighty, so that is how to run another outlet with 12-2 Romex to another box where the power is, and that's a double box with two outlets in it. So I showed you how to wire them all in series, but we used a wire nut to cap all our ground wires together and pigtail to each outlet. Peace. Thanks for watching.